C10 Talk, episode 172. Traxxas. Yep, Traxxas. Why not? Here we go.
So for under $200, someone can get started with one of our buggies, our two-wheel drive monster trucks, a two-wheel drive stadium truck, and that actually includes the battery and a fast charger in the box.
Damn, son. Vintage Air. Their SureFit kits are the best value and the most completely engineered AC systems you can install in your truck. The choice is obvious. VintageAir.com. Whether you're looking to replace your original steering, update those old brakes, or improve your suspension and handling, Classic Performance Products has got your classic truck covered. You can save 10% by using code C10TALK at checkout. 10%. ClassicPerform.com. When it comes to upgrading your truck's gauges, look no further than Dakota Digital and their wide selection of direct fit instrument systems. Hit up DakotaDigital.com for more information. If you're looking for aftermarket parts for your C10 truck, Pro Performance is your go-to source. They carry the top brands for wheels, brakes, suspension, and accessories. Check them out on the web at azproperformance.com. That's azproperformance.com.
Let me tell you what Melbourne Post is packing right here. I've got 411 Posi Track Outback, 750 Double Pumper, Edelbrock Intakes, Ford Over 30, 11-1 pop-up pistons, turbojet, 390 horsepower. We're talking some fucking muscle.
What does that do? Does that blow your mind? That just happened.
Welcome to C10 Talk, your C10 truck podcast.
And now I have a chance to be the best, maybe the best in the world.
My old man is a television repairman. Got the ultimate set of tools. I can fix it.
I said I got 50 cents in that jukebox, and all I can hear is your mouth clapping. You hear that?
Here's your host, Ronnie Wetch.
What's up, what's up? C10 Nation, how you guys doing? I hope you're holding up, and you know, this thing's a bitch. I'm not going to pretend to know how you're doing. I don't. I'm sure this virus, it's a nasty mofo, and it's affecting you all in your own way, whether that's work, whether that's family, whether that's friends, and it sucks. So I just think we're going to make the best out of it. We got to be strong. We got to, you know, hold together and take the best from what we can. For me personally, more time with the kids. I mean, we're enjoying it for the most part. You know, like I said before, I've got three teenagers, but again, I'm not going to pretend that I know how you guys are doing. I'm thinking of y'all. I know, you know, from a community, from, you know, the U.S., from everything. I mean, we're all kind of thinking, man, we got to get through this, and we will. And that's what's cool about it. But again, I hope, you know, and I'm also not naive to think that you guys aren't affected. Somebody out there has lost a loved one. Somebody out there has been touched by this virus. It's probably not the best choice of words, but affected by this virus. And, you know, whether that's a loved one, a cared one, somebody along the lines, friends and family. For me personally, I just found out that my mother-in-law's friend here locally in Arizona has passed. So it's, you know, 2-3 steps away, and it's right there. I believe he was pretty healthy going into it. I think he was in his 60s. So the shit's real. Joe freaking Diffie. I mean, of all people, Joe Diffie, Mr. Pickup Man. He was like 61 years old. So super sad, but the shit's getting crazy. Hopefully, you know, you're working on flattening the curve and kind of self-isolating, social distancing yourself. I went into the parts store the other day over at Napa, and they had like all the DEF fluid setting out, and they kind of had it back, you know, 6 feet from the counter, so you couldn't even get to the parts counter, because, you know, they're trying to kind of help remind everybody that you don't need to be sitting right on the parts counter going to work. So we'll see how that goes. It seems like with my schedule, every 4 days is when I'm off, and then I go back in, something different has happened, or a new policy, something like that. So it's definitely one of those things where it's changing very quickly. We're trying to keep up with it. Society is, so on and so forth. I was thinking about skipping this week, just getting ready and geared up for the next month of April and the 3 out of 4 weeks, you know, or however kind of works out, trying to do 3 episodes a month. But I said, screw it. I'm like, listen, let's just keep them going, because I feel like it's kind of a small little way for me to help out, me to support you guys and show you that, hey, we're all in this together and we're thinking of you guys and we're thinking of each other. And the C10 Nation is just part of it. You know, the trucks are cool, but you, the C10 Nation, the people, the listeners, you're cooler. And we got to get through this. And if I can help out by reaching out to somebody, having a fun interview, then that's what it's all about. That's how I can contribute. And you know that I enjoy that. So I reached out to Duston Nixon from Traxxas. I had met him at SEMA. He reached out to his marketing manager, Damron Atkins. We threw it together. We made it happen. It was a lot of fun. And these things are rad. So hopefully you dig it. Let's jump over and do a few reviews real quick. If you haven't had a chance to do that, please take the time to give us a review on iTunes, share the pod, subscribe to the pod. We appreciate that. It really helps us out. So for the guys that took the time to do it, we appreciate it. Let's start off here with Holman and Lightning sent me over. That's a fun, fun podcast. If you guys haven't had a chance to listen to it, the Truck Show podcast, Holman and Lightning. What a fun group of guys. 5 stars by Mafia John. The guys over at the Truck Show podcast sent me this way. Love what you do. Although I'm still more of an F100 guy. Much love from Bakersfield, California. That's okay, John. If you like old trucks, we still like you. We just like the best ones. Appreciate it. 5 stars.
If I just started, perfect. Thank you.
Builder, 5 stars from G All Good 13. Love this podcast. Keeps me up to date with everything C10 related. Builder, 5 stars. Thanks for doing that.
If I just started, perfect. Thank you.
Lifted, Lowered, Never Stock, 5 stars by Break It. Good content. I'm a 4x4 guy, but I still really enjoy this podcast. Lots of good info. Break It, 5 stars. Thanks for doing that.
If I just started, perfect. Thank you.
I need to get more 4x4 guys on here. And let's make that happen. I got a couple down on my list, so I need to kind of really dig in. It's just that them two-wheel drive guys, those slam guys, those high horsepower guys, they keep coming back, and which is a good problem because we got a ton of content out there. Speaking of high horsepower, over on the OBS podcast, OBS Talk, I just dropped episode 10 with Jason Dozier. Now, Jason is the husband to Miss Maggie Dozier, and she was on C10 Talk way back in the day with her Blue 66 that her and Jason built. Jason Dozier has an 89 OBS that he's got all souped up, and we had a great time hashing it up, talking about his motor swap, talking about his 5.7 drop, and what he's done to that 89 CK OBS truck. So jump over there and check out OBS Talk episode 10. Okay, so what else is going on? Let's go Tiger Kings and Ozark. So what are we doing to kind of pass the time when we're home? Tiger Kings, it's all the rage. I don't know what I'd give it from a rating perspective. It's entertaining, and I'm glad that it's not much more than, I guess it's probably like 6 episodes or 6 shows. After that, if I even make it that far, I think I'm into 4 episodes. It's definitely one of those things where I can't take it more than 1 show at a time, because it takes a lot to keep my attention span. So Tiger Kings, it's kind of classless but funny and entertaining in the perspective of that there's so many crazy people out there and the shit that goes on in our world. Ozark, if you are not watching Ozark, I would say Ozark is kind of like Breaking Bad. I'm a big fan of Breaking Bad, which was on, what was that, on FX Network. Ozark is on Netflix. It's season 3. It just opened on Friday, and it's entertaining. I think they hit a home run because everybody's stuck at home and they dropped it on Friday. And with Netflix, if you guys don't know this, when they drop a show like that, a season, they drop them all. So that's almost sad because they know people are just going to binge watch the shit out of it, which probably happens a lot. So Ozark season 3, I did start it on Friday. So I've probably about 4 or 5 episodes into it. It's entertaining. Ozark, I highly recommend it. One thing I'm looking to do in the next 2 weeks, you guys, is I want to know what you think. I'm going to go out and sit down with 5 to 6 guys that I've reached out to. They've agreed to do it. I'm going to call it the C10 Talk Builder Series. And what I'm going to do is go to YouTube Live, go to Instagram Live, and we are going to sit down with, I'll give you an example, Big Ten Bowman. I'm going to sit down with Jason. Jason was on the LS conversion episode I did way back in the day with Pro Dyno. Jason and Charles both worked at Pro Dyno. Jason's out on his own. You know, he went to Shifting Gears with Aaron for a while, and now he's back. He has his own shop. But Jason is a specialist when it comes to putting a motor in, whether that's an LS LT swap, whether that's a Cummins, whether that's a Duramax. He's an exhaust guy. He's a turbo guy. So what I've done is reached out to a handful of builders in the Phoenix metro area. They've all agreed to do it. And then what we're going to do is say, okay, here's their specialty. Here's what we're going to talk about. Shoot us some questions. Tune in live at this time. And we'll sit down for 30, maybe 45 minutes. We'll see how it goes. And we'll just kind of have a interactive interview. I'll be somewhat of the moderator. And then they'll be the guest, and you, the C10 Nation, or anybody, even if maybe John, Mafia John, from Ford 100 Nation wants to chime in, he can chime in. I don't care. But it'll be on Instagram. I'll run it through the C10 Talk format on my Instagram channel and on the YouTube channel as well. So, Builder Series, let me know what you think. You can email me at Ronnie at C10Talk. And also, you can leave me a voicemail if you go to C10Nation.com, right there on the homepage. You can take a listen, just hit the button, boom, it sends me a little voice message, and I can hear it and see what you guys think about the Builder Series. I can tell you, Metal Ox, the guy that cuts all the trucks down, Johnny G, Johnny G's Garage, Caesar from Matador's Customs, who is paint, body, sandblasting, and powder coating, so that ought to be a good one. AZ High Test, Mr. Jason Berland, who is, he's your tubular guy, he's your air management guy. He, if you don't follow Arizona High Test, jump over there and you'll get to see some sexy suspension, some sexy chassis. He's, in my mind, he's kind of the artistry that goes underneath the sheet metal. When you think about the chassis, you think about the airlines, you think about the wiring, you think about all the different tubular fuel lines, everything that goes on, that's kind of Jason's specialty. He was with Switch Suspension over there for a while, and now he's out on his own, and that's Arizona High Test, Jason Berlin. So I reached out to those guys. From the OBS perspective, we're going to hang out with Travis Delgarian, AZ Pro Performance, and those guys are always cranking on some kind of CK truck, whether that's a Tahoe, a truck, they're lowering it, putting some brakes on it, LS swapping them, so a lot going on there. Builder Series, let me know what you think. All right, guys, last thing, and I have to say it because I thought it was so funny when I was looking over all this stuff, is Damron, who is the marketing manager, who comes in. How did I not figure this out? His name is Damron. I mean, come on, Damron. How awesome is that? I love this guy. All right, man, I hope you guys dig Traxxas. Let me know how we're doing. Give us a rate, give us a review, shoot me an email, let me know who you want to hear from. You know, that's kind of, I've got a list, but I'm open to hearing from you guys. Let me know somebody you gotta have. Shoot me an email, Ronnie at C10Talk, R-O-N-N-I-E at C10Talk, or leave me a voice message on the homepage, C10Nation.com. All right, guys, hope you have a great week. Stay safe out there. Late. All right. What up, C10 Nation? How about a little Traxxas talk today? We've got Damron, who's the marketing manager, and Duston, who's the content marketing manager. They're both out of Texas. They're kind of socializing, or, you know, in place, at home, social distancing. And I thought, what a good time to get these guys on, talk a little bit of RC cars, and really some of that heritage that you guys have brought back. So, Damron and Duston, welcome to C10 Talk.
Hey, thanks for having us.
Yeah, appreciate you having us on.
Okay, guys, how are things going from the RC, you know, Traxxas perspective? How are you guys doing? You got a lot of cool stuff coming out. I met Duston at SEMA, and you guys are dropping some really cool retro style cars, or covers, if you will, on us.
Yeah, so the stuff we had on display at SEMA, there was the 69 K5 Blazer, and then the 72 Blazer as well. Those are new bodies that are going to be available on the TRX4, the scale and trail crawler platform. So that truck is a good all-around platform to be able to go out and do like the rock crawling, off-road kind of stuff, as well as you know, hitting the trail and driving a little bit faster. It's got a two-speed transmission, so you can run up higher speeds if you want to get it out and drive it around like a regular, more conventional RC car. And then, the low gear, you can get in and do some technical crawling with it as well. It's a really capable truck.
Yeah, I assume it's kind of new, but the videos where guys will take these old, you know, style, Broncos and the Blazers and the video content of somebody in that low gear, and they make it look like it's so realistic. It's in the wash, it's in the water, and they're going up a little, you know, a little embankment, and it looks scalable. I mean, it looks so real. Is that something new that's really kind of come about lately?
It is, and Traxxas is known for performance and innovation, and we've been pushing the boundaries of speed since I started with the company 15 years ago, going from trucks that would max out at 30 to 40 miles an hour. And now we have an on-road supercar that will actually drive over 100 miles an hour. So we've taken that performance aspect and started something new, what we call Pro Scale. And we took a lot of inspiration from the existing enthusiasts out there that were already custom building their own rigs, and took that scale detail of the body styling, the tires and wheels, getting all the proportions just right, and blending that together with the performance of, you know, the high-low remote shifting transmission, the portal axles, the remote lockable differentials, so that people could take what we built with the Pro Scale and add to it and add their own custom twists and things of, you know, adding interiors or adding our LED light kits, tinting the windows, and getting those videos and photos where you, it's extremely difficult to tell the difference if it's a full-size truck or an RC truck. And I think that's part of the fun and the fantasy of RC, is people can live out their full-size adventures on the scaled-down version and vice versa.
Well, it's a lot cheaper, to be honest with you.
Versus scaled down too. So yeah, they start around $200. To get into a fully ready to run truck. And that's going to be like one of our stadium trucks. And the price goes up gradually from there as you get into the 4x4s and as they get bigger and go faster.
Being a, you know, Chevy truck podcast, and obviously a fan, an addict, somebody like you kind of said, somebody who you're looking at the guys that really like a certain style and have that passion. How, take us through how much work it was to get that scalable model. You know, are you guys just looking at old school stuff? Are you buying a Blazer, a truck? Are you, how are you working with GM? And you know, what does that entail?
So yeah, for one example of that, on the current K5 Blazer, I actually worked in our art department while we were developing that. And we literally had like trim pieces and the grills and stuff off of a real truck that we had ordered from, you know, one of the aftermarket companies. And to tell you about the detail level that goes into it, our product manager is a staunch square body guy. He's just diehard. We went through revision after revision to get the body right, to get all the curvature of the, you know, the sides of the square body are very particular. We went through and found, you know, emblems on eBay that were, you know, the original emblems, because the reproduction ones just aren't quite, you know, there's just this or that that's just not quite the right detail about it. And all of that detail goes into, you know, making the little decals that go on the trucks, and then, you know, the trim and the grill and all of those details were, you know, fanatical about it. And, you know, it's all about getting that finished product that captures, you know, the full spirit of the full size truck. Work closely with GM to make sure everything's up to their standards as well. They've been a really cool partner to work with as well.
So I have a Blazer, and I'm blown away at the level of detail from the trim, the emblems. And it's, you know, a lot of times where you go back 5-10 years ago and you see different models of things that are really kind of, they're just shitty. They're not to the same level. You guys took it to a whole nother level of, you know, just the detail. And then, like Damron was saying, when people now make these videos, whether that's you guys initially creating the video, and then now I'm sure the hobbyist will make his or her own video, and then it somewhat goes, you know, viral, if we can use that word right now. it's so cool to see that. And there's times where I've literally seen the videos and I'm like, is that real? And then you kind of, you know, scale it back and you see that it's somebody making a, you know, video content. So the detail is absolutely awesome. It's got to be fun. It's probably tedious to work in that art department and kind of, you know, go through some of those different nuances to make somebody know, hey, well, this is exactly what we're looking for. How do you decide what model you're going to go after? You know, where did you guys kind of come up with, thinking back to that second gen Blade or Bronco, and then you guys went with the Blazer, the square body Blazer, and now you're going back to the first series Blazer, the 69 to 72. Where are you guys coming up with, you know, what's next?
Based on the parking lot at Traxxas, we have a lot of gearheads, a lot of hot rod enthusiasts, muscle cars. And so from our CEO and president all the way down through the company to Duston, who's into racing, full-size cars, there are a lot of automotive enthusiasts at Traxxas. And so that's where it stems from. I mean, me personally, I grew up around the late 70s GMC Jimmy. I had a K5 in the family for a while, and we are car and truck guys and gals. And so that's where a lot of the passion stems from, that turns into these projects that you see, from the 79 Bronco to the 79 Blazer, replica Mustang cars, replica Ford GT, Corvette C7, CTSV. So we've worked closer and closer with our licensing partners, with Land Rover on the Land Rover Defender, which was one of our first replicas on the TRX4 platform, and continue to put out what we think enthusiasts will be interested in and what they're going to want and really appreciate and get into. And then we also stay really closely in touch with our customers, both through social media, through forums, just all different channels. We're plugged in, we're interacting with them, seeing what they're interested in. And then that's a lot of times where you'll see inspiration taken from there in future products that we release.
Where do you guys find in that is your most popular currently?
It kind of bounces around. I think obviously whenever we release a new, you know, a new body style, like the 79 Blazer, whenever it came out, it obviously there was a lot of demand initially, because we've had people telling us for years, you know, oh, I need the Chevy. You know, we had Ford licensing for a long time, and then getting the GM deal and getting the Blazer, you know, that had some pent up demand there, I think. So it kind of bounces back and forth. The crawlers as a whole have just been really popular for, you know, going on 3 years now for us. So I think it's that scale detail, and then being able to capture the love and the classic style, that full size car, and, you know, having it be attainable and having something that you can go and roll it off the side of the hill down the rocks and not have to worry about, you know, fixing it up, because the trucks are super durable, and pick it back up and do it again.
Some other really popular products, you asked kind of what's hot right now. We have a new TRX6, which is a six wheel drive, three axle scale Mercedes G63 replica. That's just beautiful, and it has fully functional LED lights, and the detail on it is amazing. That has been extremely popular for us since that's a more recent product release. In addition to that, we're known for monster trucks. We're known for big trucks that go fast. You can jump them and just bash them around a big open field or a park or a skate park or construction site. So we have a new truck called the Max, which is a four-wheel drive monster truck. Thing does like 65 plus miles an hour, pulls wheelies for days. And that's an incredibly fun truck that's incredibly durable. And we're having a blast with it. And it's showing by customer pull through at the moment too.
You know, I think in this current time, we're kind of stuck at home. You know, we're social distancing. Some people are quarantined. You guys are working individually from home. We're seeing that in, you know, the last few weeks. What a good time to kind of get yourself, like you said, you could maybe find your old car, dig it out, charge the battery, or get a new project. Are you guys kind of seeing an uptick in some of that?
Yeah, we're seeing it on especially social media. Our social team is like just jamming day and night, trying to keep up with, you know, the content that people are sending to us, and the, you know, the questions about getting their old car back going again, or seeing just, you know, what different people are sharing and what they're doing with these cars. It's definitely an interesting time with people having this much free time on their hands.
Yeah, I've been in my garage more lately, wrenching on my own personal stuff, so I can relate to a lot of our customers.
How'd you guys get into RC cars? Were you like Dustin, you're a race fanatic, or you're a race fan? Were you a race fan and then an RC car guy, or how does that work?
So I got into RC whenever I was a kid. My parents actually got into model airplanes, and I grew up at the flying field with them flying planes, and didn't really like the flight side of it. Didn't really interest me that much, but I quickly found the RC cars. And at that time, you know, Nitro was the hot ticket, you know, and had a couple different Nitro Stadium trucks, and, you know, would go out and drive the trucks around while they were flying the planes, and got out of it for a while. We got into full size cars, built a 63 C10, and got into racing stuff, and circled back around on it around 2013, 2014, became familiar with Traxxas again, you know, all those years later, and ended up getting to come work here. So
yeah, that's pretty cool. Damron, how about you? You've been in the Traxxas business for a long time.
I have. Yeah, I got into this, I'm dating myself here a little bit, back in the mid 80s when I was a young kid, and just kind of got hooked ever since. Been in RC on and off throughout the years, you know, same as Duston, got into high school, learned about full size cars and girls, and kind of got distracted a little bit from the hobby, but then got back into it. And I actually worked part time in hobby stores in high school and in college, and been a RC racer for years and years. When I worked in a hobby store in Tucson, Arizona, actually, that's when the Traxxas T-Max was launched, which completely turned the industry upside down. We were stacking them up to the ceiling all over the store, selling them out every week, get more in the next week, sell more. So I had the privilege of seeing Traxxas grow from the street level, so to speak, where I was actually behind the counter talking to customers, helping them out, breaking in engines day in, day out. And after that, actually made a career out of the hobby. And so I get to do what I love every day and get to promote this amazing hobby and these great, highly innovative products to families and kids and all different people at trade shows and events. So it's been a blessing for me to have this passion and to be able to share it with other people.
That's awesome. I mean, you get to kind of do what you love, and, you know, we've heard it 1,000 times, or if you're doing what you love, you don't really have a job. And it's fun to see that. Now, you talked a little bit about the trade shows. When I go to, namely, Barrett Jackson, what a fun way you guys have of, you know, it's not a typical booth where you think like you go to a trade show or something. You guys, even at SEMA, you guys are doing, you know, it's like a circus show. Guys are doing flips and, you know, what's the indie, or I'm trying to think of the backflip from the one show with Rodney Dangerfield, the triple whatever.
Lindy?
Yeah, the triple Lindy. These guys, I'm just amazed at, and they land it every time. I know it takes a little bit more space to have that set up, but you guys definitely do a good job with, you know, since we do have marketing guys on, putting that together. How much fun is that to do? C10 Nation, let me tell you about my buddies, Travis, his dad Jack, aka Dad, and Nick. They run Pro Performance, AZ Pro Performance. They're active in our community. They're C10 guys. They're always working on new stuff, like their new suspension line, React Suspension. They're master dealers for Accuair, Dakota Digital, Behr, Boyd Welding, Vintage Air, and many more. They're C10 specialists and stock many fast-moving products backed by their stellar customer service. Not only do they sell C10 parts, but they live and breathe C10s and are very active in our community. Like I said, look for them at your next truck show. Nick might be there if they let him out, but usually Travis and his dad, Jack, and they want to talk to you and help you out with your C10 project. Follow them on Instagram, Facebook, and you can also check out their Facebook group called C10 Addiction. So check them out and let them know that I sent you. Hey guys, I have Greg Carpe from Dakota Digital on. Greg, why should we choose Dakota Digital?
Ronnie, I think we're the best. If you want something that looks cool and fits in the dash, we've got that. If you want something that's going to work with either a 327 or an LS3 or anything in between, we can do that. We've got a ton of direct fit instrument systems for all these pickups, and then we've got some modules that'll plug into the computer for your LS, your LT, pull all the info straight out of the computer, put it in the cluster. So it's really the easiest, most functional, most user-friendly package on the market.
I agree. And the cool thing is, from the modern perspective of technology, you can even use your phone if you need to.
Yeah, our HDX and RTX lines of instrumentation, so our newest platforms we've released, do have a mobile app, and you can put that on your phone or your tablet. So not only speed calibration and color selections and all of the setup parameters can be done on your phone or tablet, you can also run the real-time gauges. So if you're, say, under the hood working on something, you can have the oil pressure and the coolant temp pulled up so you don't have to run back and forth. So the app is really a nice upgrade on these.
You want the look, you want the performance, and you want to be able to see your gauges, Dakota Digital. Thanks, Greg.
Thank you, Ronnie.
How much fun is that to do?
I can tell you I've been a part of that since the inception in Traxxas, and it's been a wild ride. It's been a ton of fun. We go to Boy Scout jamborees, NHRA events. You mentioned Barrett Jackson, the car auctions. We were a sponsor of NHRA and Courtney Force and John Force for many years. So we went to 24 NHRA events per year and got to meet a lot of fantastic people out on the road and share the fun of the hobby with them. And like you mentioned, we have the ramp set up. We call it the fun box where we do our demonstrations, and we'll jump the trucks and do backflips and all different kinds of tricks and show off the performance and the durability. But then at the same time, for people who are at the events, we give them the opportunity to actually test drive the trucks. So sometimes we'll have our scale trucks set up where we have a rock crawling area and people can test drive the TRX4s like the Blazer. And we'll also set up a test area where people can test drive our short course trucks and drive them around a small track with a couple little ramps and jumps and things. And those trucks are in what we call training mode. So they are slowed down to about 50%, which is a feature in all of our electric trucks, which is great for like kids and first time drivers learning how to operate the vehicles. And once they get the hang of it with, you know, if they purchase a truck, they can put it back into what we call a sport mode, which is full power, 100%, and unleash, you know, all the power and speed that's available.
I need to get mine more in sport modes on my Blazer. Sometimes I feel like my kids are driving it around, so I need to maybe this week you'll motivate me to get it more in sport mode and kind of see if I can't tear it up a little bit more. Can you use different bodies? So when you guys release that 69 to 72 Blazer, will that work on my 79 Blazer?
Yeah, so they're designed to be interchangeable, especially the ones on the TRX4, that crawler platform. You'll need to adjust the body mounts a little bit, but it's, you know, a couple of little hex screws. You pull it out, adjust the body mounts up and down a little bit. That kit will come with different bumpers too, so you get the correct bumpers for whatever your model. So it's the complete, you know, it's the complete truck that all looks correct. And the body kits will come with instructions on the inside of exactly where you need to position everything, you know, the number of holes that need to be visible on the mounts, all that stuff. So it's no guesswork. You follow the instructions, it drops the body on there and it looks like what it's supposed to.
Do you see a lot of guys doing that with different platforms? They get a, you know, the Blazer platform, then you got the more of a long bed truck platform. Do you see guys kind of having, you know, multiple shells, and then they get to have a whole conglomerate and different, you know, from I feel like this on Saturday and I feel like this on Wednesday?
Yeah, definitely. So the scale side of the hobby is really crazy with the lengths that people go to with customizing the trucks. I think more so than any of the other aspects of the hobby. You've got guys that, you know, do the full scale detailing where you're adding the, you know, the ropes and winches and all this different, you know, all these different like full size details to the smaller truck. And then, yeah, the number of bodies, you know, we offer a wide range of bodies, and then there's, you know, a large aftermarket as well. So there's the possibilities are completely endless with what you can do with the trucks, both from an appearance standpoint and from a performance standpoint. We sell, you know, different, like we sell weight kits to go on the front to weight down the front axle to help it perform better in climbs and, you know, out in the rocks, that kind of stuff. Upgraded servos. I mean, the light, you know, full light kits. The possibilities are just really endless with it.
What do you see as being some of the most popular upgrades? Let's say on like a TRX4 style platform.
So performance wise, the like best bang for your buck you can do is the weights on the axle. So they actually mount on the outer, we've got a portal axle on the truck. So it steps down, gives you some added ground clearance. We've got a brass weight that attaches onto that axle. So you put a lot of extra weight on the truck down low, way up front, helps the weight bias move a lot further forward and helps you with climbing up steep hills and just really transforms the truck. From an appearance and scale standpoint, people absolutely love the light kits. They've got all the different, you've got headlights, parking lights, taillights, everything is there on the truck. And it's just really transforms the look of it overall. That scale realism, you can get out after dark and drive it around. And we've got rock lights to go on the fender wells. So you light up all the whole area under the truck. And it's all plug and play, super easy to install. There's no soldering or anything crazy like that at all. Just attaches to the body and you plug it in and go.
I just love it. It's like a real truck. It's just they can snowball from. We can just keep adding parts and lights and more performance. So go ahead, Damron. Sorry.
Yeah, I was gonna say, and some of my favorite add-ons for the Blazer. We have an actual lift kit that's just like a lift kit you might get from a full parts or someplace like that for a full size truck. It keeps all of the suspension geometry correct, does a full lift. And then we have larger tires and wheels. So the stock wheel is a 1.9 inch diameter. So we have a 2.2 inch. So kind of like putting a big mudder on your truck, and they're actually beadlock wheels. So it's a multi-piece wheel that clamps the tire onto the wheel. And has a larger diameter tire, and it just gives it a really cool off-road look. It looks like a jacked up K5. And then another really cool accessory that we have are all-terrain tracks. So like tank tracks, basically, for the front and rears. And those are great for like loose sand, mud, any other kind of really loose material, like going through water and things like that. They release the water almost instantly. So just really cool accessories. You can check them out on Traxxas.com. It's kind of like full-size cars and trucks. The customization and the different little, changing the colors of things or doing underdrive and overdrive with the gears, adding heavy-duty axles, aluminum upgrades to customize the color of things. We have like different color anodized parts, green, red, blue, and a really cool gray, like gunmetal color. So it's really fun on what people can do, and you can make it look just like your full size truck, which is another neat thing. I saw that desert sunset truck that you guys had posted on your Facebook that looked really cool.
Yeah, I think that was so Desert Fox, which is, you kind of brought it up earlier. You got that late 70s Jimmy, 77, and our friend Big Fish, who's out of Nebraska. He put it together and they made that thing, and they even put the GMC, decals on there and everything. And so that's just cool. Like, the scale guys, you think about the older, for me, it's the older dudes with the trains in their backyard. And I remember when I was younger, when my son was younger and I was younger too, and we would, he's like 4 years old and he was so into those, and we would go all over Phoenix and just go on these tours, and these guys would convert their whole backyard. And it sounds like the RC guys aren't much different, or it could potentially be the same group of, lineage, where guys are making these scalable off-road tracks and come over, we're going to drink beer and we're going to, when we can all hang out again, and we're going to just have these off-road competitions. So I pulled mine up here. I got my box here. I was thinking it looks like it's probably about a 6-inch lift with 35s is kind of how I would say stock. Sounds like what you're saying, Damron, is almost like you're taking it up to the old Super Swamper flying high 44s. You can really upgrade that. So I'll have to get online, and I'm definitely intrigued by the tracks. Now, the track you mentioned, I'm assuming that's four separate style tracks. It's not like a tank where it's complete.
Correct.
Okay, yeah, so they're individual.
Like a half track, so it's four individual track sets for each corner of the truck, and then we have a new tread for it that's a deep terrain tread, so it really grabs in like snow and powdery snow and sand. It just has a more aggressive tread pattern with a little deeper kind of claws on it, so to speak, and the thing is pretty much unstoppable. It can ascend up some really steep inclines in loose terrain, and we've shot some videos with those recently, and it's impressive as to what what the truck can do with those attached to it.
What about the remote control? Do you guys, is there any upgrade there that people do much, or for this perspective, is it pretty capable for everything that it needs to do?
So yeah, out of the box, the radio system, it's 2.4 gigahertz. It's got multiple model memories. So if you have more than one truck, you can control them all with a single radio. You've got the one that comes with the TRX4. You've got full customization as far as your throttle and steering trim and endpoints and all that stuff. The biggest add-on you can do for it, we call it the Traxxas Link Wireless Module. So it's about $35-$40. You add it to it and you can actually connect to it with an app on your phone we call Traxxas Link. So that gives you full access to all of the different customization possibilities. For the crawler specifically, we have a real-time inclinometer gauge, so you can actually see the angle that the truck is, you know, pitching to one side or the other, or, you know, what kind of angle you're climbing or descending at. It's super fun to watch it in real time as it's going. It's like the old gauges that you had on the dashboard of your Suzuki Samurai back in the 90s. So you could tell whenever it was about to roll over and you knew to back out of it.
I think these can go faster than a Suzuki Samurai, to be honest with you. I don't think my buddy had a Samurai and I think it probably had like 33s and we could not go over 45 miles an hour. We literally were kind of skeptical whether or not we would go on the freeway because we were somewhat, you know, we're too slow for here in Phoenix. And I just remember how much fuel it would produce or exhaust, and it would just eddy back on us, and we just felt like we were dying. So we were like, oh, it looks so cool, this little Samurai, but not so much anymore. So these are definitely cooler. The detail is amazing. It's just on point. Whoever takes pictures and puts these on the covers of the boxes and everything, if that's you guys and your team, you guys are killing it, because the detail sucks you in. I mean, I don't know specifically the demographic for overall Traxxas, but for me and my genre, it's captivating. It makes me want to buy another one. I'm literally looking at my box thinking, gosh, I should buy the red and black one. I've already got the burnt orange and white one. And I saw online some guy, I don't know if you guys are coming out with it or some guy made it, but it's a blue and white one. So I'm just like, dude, they're going to keep, I mean, I'm sure the shells are just going to keep, guys are going to keep painting them and redoing them.
Yes. So we sell clear accessory bodies for pretty much everything we make, especially the scale trucks. So if you've got a full size one that you're wanting to make a miniature replica of, you buy that clear body and get some Lexan paint, and that the sky's the limit on, you know, the customization you can do on the paint as well.
Yeah. We recommend painting them on the inside, because that way it doesn't get all scraped up on the outside. But some people will actually mask it off on the inside and then do a little additional spray paint or Lexan paint on the outside, so that when it does scuff up, it gives a little texture. And people get really creative with it. I mean, it's just like painting a full-size car or truck, just this one. The beauty is you can roll it over, nobody gets hurt, and you can drive them fast and hard and flip them back over if you crash them and just keep going.
Do you think that people learn how to, obviously this is completely, I'm not holding you liable for this, but I just wonder if you feel like people learn how to drive better somewhat defensively, whether it's a TRX style four-wheel drive or it's something that, you know, hauls ass. And now, you know, we'll get into the drifting stuff too, how popular that has become. It seems like I'm going to learn how to drive better if I'm a kid and I'm learning, like, holy shit, if I autocorrect, this thing just slams into the wall. Or I'm learning how to be a better Suzuki Samurai driver, because every time I go here, I pitch here and I roll over three times, and I don't want to do that in real life.
See, I think there's two aspects to that. One, you know, learning the dynamics of the car. You know, we have full the shocks are fluid filled. They've got pistons in them with holes, so you can adjust the damping, so you can tune the suspension on the car just like you do a full size car. And then, you know, learning the mechanics of, you know, whenever I go to a stiffer shock oil, what does it do to the way that it drives? You know, something like our Unlimited Desert Racer, that's a replica of a full size trophy truck. You can do a lot of suspension tuning with it to really fine tune how it acts in different conditions, because it's got 8 large diameter shocks on it. Something where you can, you know, learn those full size dynamics in a smaller setting. And then, you know, the other aspect of it is learning the mechanical side. I know I personally grew up wrenching on these, you know, small cars, and, you know, learned the mechanical aspect of it, especially with tuning a nitro car. And, you know, that carried over whenever we started getting into full size cars, and it was just like, oh, it's just a bigger version of it, but it's all the same, you know, steering system and fuel system and engine and everything else, you know, all the gears and the drivetrain and everything. It's a similar setup. So
from the driving aspect, I know from my experience with my kids when they were young, 3 and 4 years old, I'd put a transmitter in their hands, put the truck in training mode. We're using the slash truck that has the big front bumper, and they could just drive it around the backyard, into the fence, into the garage, into the house, and it wasn't going to hurt them or the truck. And as they got older and progressed, take it out of training mode, increase the voltage of the batteries, going from 15 miles an hour to 30 miles an hour. And now my son's ripping a truck around at like 50 miles an hour, zigzagging in and out of things with precision control. And when he jumped into a go-kart, his ability and, you know, hand-eye coordination for being able to control the throttle and the steering, he was at a level that was pretty advanced for his age when he was like 10 years old, you know, getting in a kart. And all of those things he learned, I think, translate over. And Duston, you can probably speak to this from, you know, going from driving RC cars to race cars and a lot of other athletes that we've sponsored in short course off-road racing and rallycross and different motorsport genres have all mentioned, or most of them mentioned, that they grew up playing with RC cars, and that was a big inspiration and educational piece of their, you know, learning how to drive full-size cars on a racetrack. Because some of them, like Sheldon Creed that we worked with, he was running race trucks when he was like 15, 16 years old, and became a, you know, a world-class athlete at that at a very young age.
Cool to see that the kids get into it. And you know, I remember going back to the first my hot shot, you know, so I'm telling you, it's got to be like 86 or something like that, and I saved all my pennies. And you talked a little bit about it, Duston. You got to put it together. Do you still have a lot of those cars where guys can put it together? That's how my hot shot came. I know it was like the hot shot and the grasshopper, and I can't remember, there's like one other one. And you built the box, and you had your servos, and you're hooking up the steering components and the end links and the control arms, and then you didn't want to break it, but if you did break it, you knew how to fix it because you were the one who put it together.
Bulk of what we sell is actually, we call it ready to race. So it comes fully assembled, painted, ready to go out of the box. We've actually, the last couple of years, gotten back into producing some kits where, you know, it's you get a box and it's got, you know, 7 bags of parts in it. We've got a full color illustrated manual that comes with it that goes step by step through every step of the process. We handle some of the more tedious jobs, like putting the end links on the shocks and some of those, you know, things that are not really teaching you anything. It's just kind of a tedious portion of putting the kit together. It comes with a clear body on most of them, so you're able to paint up your body and make it look like you want. But yeah, you get that full experience of, you know every nut and bolt on the truck because you put the whole thing together. And so it's cool to be able to cater to both, you know, both different types of people, you know, the ones that just want to pull it out of the box and rip it, and then the others that want to, you know, make sure that they've got the right, you know, the precise amount of grease on the gear sets and all those, you know, all those little nth degree things that people like to dial in.
I think, you know, then you get the guys who really like to make their fine little tunes and little touches. And if you can assemble it, then they're going to be like, oh, well, I can upgrade that. Not to think that a guy who comes, you know, it comes road ready, race ready, but they get a whole nother level of confidence. Like, well, I built the whole damn thing. I can tear it all apart and I can upgrade this and upgrade that. And you probably would see in that, those groups, you know, that demographic, that they're probably going to be more likely to upgrade to whatever it might be, different components, versus maybe somebody who just takes it out of the box and says, oh, I'm going to race ready it. I don't know. I'm just, you know, I'm wondering.
Yeah, I don't know that we have any detailed numbers on the different types of people, but yeah, that's an interesting, it's an interesting way to think about it.
So do you guys have Atkins race night over there, Damron? Now that your son's older, do you guys have Traxxas tournaments or anything like that where you guys just kind of in-house, or do you guys get out to a lot of these race different, you know, events? Because I remember, again, back to being a kid, you know, there was tracks all around Phoenix where you could go and race them. And I'm sure there still is. It's probably overwhelming, indoor, outdoor, and everything.
Yeah, there are a handful of tracks here in Dallas-Fort Worth, but primarily what I do and my kids is we'll just go out to a local park, or, you know, just find a construction site type field, you know, where there's some rough terrain, or go to the skate park when when there aren't skaters there, and just go have a blast with the trucks, drive them, jump them, flip them. You can actually do back flips in the air if you hit the jumps just right, or front flips. And for Traxxas employees, I'd say we have the full gamut. We have the guys who are into the scale trucks, and we'll go out and take them, you know, hiking or camping. And I've taken them camping with my family before, and we'll just go cruising down the trails with them. And there are some enthusiasts out there who do race the Traxxas cars and trucks, but I would say the majority are just taking them out and having a good time at their local park, their local community, in their backyard, in a cul-de-sac, places like that.
How is the drifting looking? That seems to be something that's kind of seems to be more popular right now. So for whatever reason, obviously the retro style trucks I see are really popular. And then I see a lot of the guys that are doing the drifting. Do you guys have a lot of kind of an area of drifting that you specialize in, or is that a different company or different brand?
So we've got the Fortec on-road chassis. We actually sell specific drift tires for it. So it's an all-wheel drive chassis. So it's a little bit different drift setup than what you see, you know, with what it's more of that like Ken Block all-wheel drive style drift where you're, you know, the whole car is kind of sliding around versus, you know, just kicking the tail way far out. So those drift tires, they actually bolt right up in place of the stock ones. It's a hard plastic shell on the outside, so it's a really low grip, and the car just slides around effortlessly. So something where our standard brushed motor model that will run about 30 miles per hour, it will just annihilate these tires for as long as you want to go, and just slide around sideways and backwards and do donuts and everything else. So they're a ton of fun.
Yeah, and that's really what it's all about. And that's kind of what I'm trying to just, you know, let the audience know. I mean, we said, you know, earlier, it's like you're kind of locked up and you know, turn it into some fun stuff. Get your old car out if you have one, because honestly, mine's been sitting on the shelf, and I'm like, kids, let's get this thing charged up. Let's go out. We're having a good time. And you know, and that's kind of fun. You know, we all find these different things that we can do, and it might be individually, or you might get your family into it. So hopefully you guys are seeing that out there where, you know, different people are kind of either getting into it or recharging everything that they have.
Yep. And that's one of our biggest focuses, is on supporting the local hobby stores. So I know we're kind of in a unique situation right now. However, there are a number of hobby stores around the country that are offering, you know, curbside pickup or local home delivery and things like that to keep everybody healthy and safe. Supporting those local businesses is critical. You know, they have the Traxxas parts, the batteries, the chargers, the accessories on the wall. They've made the investments in the product, in the brand, and in servicing and supporting it. So if you're ready to get your Rustler or your Stampede or your Slash back up and running, or your TRX4 or any Traxxas model, give your local hobby shop a call. If you're not able to, you know, get in touch with them, you can always give us a call at 888-TRAXXAS. Or go to our website. We have a chat feature there, or email. We're happy to answer questions. And then you can pick up parts and vehicles on our website as well. You can likely get a better deal and a good relationship with your local hobby shop.
Well, and what better way to support them if they're able to stay open? Because like you said, it's something I don't really think about as a firefighter. I'm not really diving into that business perspective. But to think once you say that, people are... You know, these guys are like probably stressing, you know, their rent, and they've got all this money tied up in parts and cars. And with you guys having kind of the ready to rock and roll, you know, you're ready. You just order it, curbside pickup, you know, pay and go and have fun. If you need a few upgrades on parts, hit them back up over the phone, keep your distance, tell them what you need, tell them what's going on, and, you know, maybe order a pizza at the same time. Before you know it, you'll have the family out there, you're rocking, you're having a good time with your Blazer, and you're having, you know, you're eating some pizza and you're supporting the local business. That's one thing I've tried to tell people is, you know, especially from the food perspective, but I didn't even think about from the RC perspective. So I might have to go upgrade my controller or something now. Now you got me feeling I need to do something.
Yep.
You know, so for the audience, from the Blazer, it doesn't come with a battery or a charger. Most guys, I assume you guys, once they get into the hobby, they're going to have the charger. Do you have a battery that you guys recommend, or kind of a universal setup?
So yeah, on the crawlers, we've got a few different options on the batteries and the LiPo batteries. You can run either a 2-cell, which is a 7.4 volt, or a 3-cell, which is an 11.1 volt. So the basic idea is the voltage is the amount of speed that you can get out of it. So in a crawler situation, that 11.1, that 3-cell, that's going to give you more wheel speed to be able to pop the truck out of, you know, tough situations and give you a little more outright speed for whenever you're in high gear out on the trail. We offer, if you've got a charger already, we offer just the batteries individually. And then if you're coming into it fresh and getting just the truck and you've never had a truck before, we offer battery and charger completer packs for those. We've got them with the 2-cell and a 3-cell. So anywhere from like $60 up to $130, you can get the battery and charger combo and get going all in one shot.
And I don't remember what I paid for this. I want to say it was $250. Does that sound right for retail for a Blazer? Or is it $450? I really don't even remember.
$450. Yeah,
$450. Yeah, $450. Okay. Yeah, you guys were looking at me like, holy shit, he got a smoking deal on that thing. Both of their eyes just lit up and they were like, yeah, they're both in different places, but I could see Duston look at Damron and Damron look at Duston and be like, wow, he got a coupon. But okay, so $450 for the whole thing. And then you think about, you know, $60 to $134 if you need a charger and a battery. So roughly $550 and you're going to have the whole setup. Now, you said earlier, Damron, there's, you know, prices from, let's say, $250 just to get started, right?
That's correct. And so for under $200, someone can get started with one of our buggies, our two-wheel drive monster trucks, a two-wheel drive stadium truck, and that actually includes the battery and a fast charger in the box. And so as they go up, say someone wants to get started with a 4x4, they start right under $300. You get into the Mustangs, again, right under that $300 price point. So for, on average, $200 to $300, that's where someone can get started with a Traxxas vehicle. And the neat thing is the upgrade path that's available. Say, play with the car for, you know, a couple weeks or a couple months, and you're like, man, I really want to go faster. We have a power-up program where you can trade in the speed control of the motor for the brushless setup. So you can go from the 30 to 35 mile an hour setup to the 60 to 70 mile an hour setup for a discount. You know, you trade it in, you can do that through your local hobby store or directly through Traxxas. You power up to the high speed setup. And then going back to those batteries and chargers, like Duston mentioned, more voltage equals more speed. So you can upgrade to the higher voltage battery and get those higher speeds. And then getting started with the trail and scale trucks, we have a TRX4 Sport, which has locked differentials and a single speed transmission, and then a pickup truck style body. And that one starts right around $350. So you can get into a crawler for under $400 with a battery and charger and the truck.
Yeah. And I assume that because we're going after a classic style like the Blazer, that there's probably a little bit more there because you guys have to pay licensing fees and the detail to go into that. So if you want to just get in and just get in the ground floor, a regular generic style truck, $350. But if you want something more specific like I have with the Blazer, which it works, I had to have it. I mean, I couldn't wait to get it once I saw it out there. Whatever you're doing, it is working. When is the next gen Blazer coming out?
So you bought a C10 and it either had AC at one time or it wasn't even an option. Well, Vintage Air has the solution for you. Their SureFit kits are designed to place the evaporator and hoses behind the dash for a factory clean look. In most cases, the SureFit systems will be controlled by your stock dash controls using their exclusive cable converters. In some applications, a new factory look control panel is included with the kit. The SureFit systems provide full OEM-style operations, including air conditioning, floor or vent heating, and a powerful defroster. To retain a true factory look, the AC air exits through the factory dash louvers, if originally equipped in your truck. The Gen 4 kit provides infinite, just-right temperature, air blending, and blower fan speed adjustments. The Vintage Air SureFit kits are the best value and the most completely engineered air conditioning system you can install in your C10. Add the fact that Vintage Air has been the most respected name in performance aftermarket climate control systems for 40 years. 40 years? Damn, son. The choice is obvious. VintageAir.com.
Hey, guys. I've got Kathy White, Classic Performance Products, CPP on the line. Kathy, how's it going?
Hey, Ronnie. What's up?
What's up? What's new?
We've got a ton of things for the C10 community. First things first, our 2.5-inch Extreme XN drop spindle. So we've upgraded the current modular spindle to modern technology. This new XN spindle is one-piece forged, but it utilizes strong, modern, bolt-in, internally sealed bearing hub assembly. So it's low maintenance. It doesn't move the wheels out, and you can use big brakes from us or any aftermarket big brakes out there in the market.
That's awesome. What else is new?
So we have actually gone back and redesigned our aluminum fuel tanks. As you know, our fuel tanks are the thickest, strongest, and largest capacity in the industry. But now you can actually use the same tank for either a carbureted or a fuel injection application. 63 to 72, it's 20 gallons. And for 73 and newer, 22-gallon capacity.
How about that coilover kit? You guys must be killing it with that thing.
That is such a great kit. It's fully bolt-on. It's easy to install. Strongest tubular arms in the market, available with either upper and lower or just the lowers or just a coilover kit by themselves. All the mounting brackets that you need. And it also comes with dual adjustable coilover shocks. So it's really responsive. It's up to you however you want to tune the compression or the rebound. It's perfect if you're just cruising on the streets, and it's proven on the track.
Well, that's what we like. So if you need spindles, the new X10, fuel tanks, coilovers, they've got it. Classic Performance Products, CPP. And don't forget, use code C10TALK, C10TALK at checkout and save 10%. Thanks, Kathy.
Thank you, Ronnie.
When is the next gen Blazer coming out, Duston?
We still don't have a specific date on that yet. I haven't seen an update, which we find out about it about 2 weeks before the rest of the world does. So, but yeah, the best way to keep up with everything is just check out the news section on Traxxas.com, and then you can also subscribe on there and get all of our emails, and we'll definitely be letting everybody know when that's coming up.
Yeah, because I believe with social media, that's, you know, that's obviously how kind of we do most of ours, through Instagram. And I remember at SEMA seeing, you know, the display. I think the owner had like a black 69 to 72. It was very well done. And then there on the shelves, you guys had all the, which is funny because it's the next gen for you guys, but it's the previous gen for us. So the 69 to 72 first gen Blazers are out. They're going to be, you know, they're going to be fun. And I don't know. I don't think I want a separate shell. I just want the whole Blazer so I can have both Blazers sitting there. So that will be exactly what I end up doing. So maybe instead of not getting the black and the red and black K5 square, I'll just wait until that Blazer. I would think if you guys had them at SEMA, it's got to be any time now. I mean, any hint, anything?
I'll take a stab. I'll say hopefully sometime in 2020 is the time frame there. But yeah, it could be here in the next few months. But I wouldn't, since we don't have anything official yet, I wouldn't wait. I would pick up the 79, and then like Duston mentioned, we have the body kits. So if you want to, you know, retrofit from the 79 and go to the 69 or 72, we'll likely have body kits for those. So you'll be able to switch back and forth between the two. We'll have the correct time period bumpers, tires, wheels. You know, we take the details very seriously. So you can retrofit it, and then we potentially will have it ready to run later down the line. But those details will be coming out as they're available.
What would be the holdup on something like that if we saw it at SEMA? What's kind of, you know, because I mean, I think everything's, I guess, walk me through what you can say or not say. What would you say would be the biggest holdup on something like that? Anticipating, because we did see it at SEMA 2019. I remember kind of showing, I did a little video on it, and I was like, so, you know, I was like, oh, this has got to be out. And then, yeah, what's going on?
That's to be determined is the best thing I can say is, with, everything that's happening right now, I'm not exactly sure, you know, in the world at the moment, but our product development team keeps everything very close to the vest. And when a new product's ready, we want to make sure it's exactly dialed in and ready. So if there are any of those last minute details and things, they get, a lot of attention put on them. And I would just, yeah, follow us on Facebook, follow us, follow Traxxas on Instagram, sign up for our newsletter, and as information's available, we will get it out to you.
Do you know if you can tell us, but the color combos, because you guys hit it out of the park on the square body Blazer. Do you know the color combos or perceived color combos on the first gen?
I haven't seen anything official on it yet. That's if there's a specific color combination that people want to see, they should they can definitely go let us know, because I think it's still up in the air. I'm not 100% sure, but.
Okay, where do I just tell you right now, or where do I direct my audience to petition a color combo for the first gen Blazer, because I got a few in mind.
So it's funny, we actually have a group of people that continually tell us what they want to see in our Facebook post comments and in Instagram comments as well. It's funny, there's so many people spitballing so many different things that whenever we come out with something, there's always at least one person that's like, I predicted it, I knew it.
Yeah, and then you get all the people who's like, why didn't you do this, or why didn't you do this? And you're like, oh my God, people, I can't win for losing. I've got a few different shirt designs and sticker designs, and people come back at me all the time, and they're saying, you know, why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do this? And you're like, I'm just trying to please as many as I can. I actually came out, and I'm going to send you guys some. But I came out with I have all these stickers, and it shows like the rear tailgate bumper. And they're like, well, why do you always just do the slam stuff? Why don't you have the four-wheel drive? So I'm like, okay, well, versus coming out with a whole new sticker, I just made axles. And then those guys can set those same, you know, tailgate rear view picture or, you know, sticker on their axle. So they can go 1-inch lift. They can go 6-inch lift. They can, you know, back and forth. So I'll send you guys some of that, because you're just trying to make people happy and do the best you can. So it'll be fun to see what I'm going to predict that one of them's okra, which is the yellow, the mustard yellow. And I'm going to, you know, petition for that. And there's also a burnt orange that I really like. Those came out in the 69s and the 70s. Those are rare, very popular. So those are the two popular colors, probably the easiest ones to go after. But yeah, I'll leave a comment on Instagram or Facebook, and we'll kind of go from there. What would you guys, if you both could pick anyone that you wanted, whether it was a race car, whether it was an off-road TRX4 style, what would you guys pick? We'll go with Damron first.
All right, I'm going to go with X-Max, which may have been Dustin's pick. But that's our big, it's like a 21-pound monster truck. It's close to 3 feet long. It does 50 miles an hour. It'll pull wheelies for days and eat up pretty much any terrain that's in its path. It is the biggest, the baddest. The power-to-weight ratio is just spot on. And, with X-Max, you can't go wrong. It does have the highest price tag, but with that, you get the most fun, I would say, in terms of just being able to drive in places where some of our other cars, you know, get eaten up in the craters. This truck just plows through it and can go pretty much anywhere.
What's that retail?
Right around $949. And then you'd need to add your completer pack and your batteries and chargers. You're right about $1,000 all in.
So, Dustin, my question was a little different, but why don't you go with that same question and see what you answer?
So what was different about it? Sorry.
Well, I think the way I would rephrase it would be if you could create any vehicle. So, for example, 5 years ago, if we said you'd make a first gen Blazer, second gen Blazer, the second gen Bronco. So meaning if you got your input, what would you create for Traxxas? What's your favorite style that isn't out there right now? But with what you do have, you know, what would you go with?
So I'm going to get a little personal here. I want a 60 to 66, preferably 60 to 63 style body for the TRX4 with a short wide bed on it, just because that's what I have at home. So that's just me being a little bit selfish. But yeah, and that same style body as an on-road platform would be even better, just because our truck is, well, right now it's in 1,000 pieces, but it's
only 1,000.
Only 1,000. Yeah. So it's in the process of getting the full no limit suspension treatment on it right now. But that's my soft spot is the 60 to 63s, especially with the wraparound windshield and sure, the Corvette looking dash. And yeah, that's what I'm shoving in the suggestion box every week at work is we need to build this truck.
Yeah, that might be a better way to kind of rephrase that question. What would you put in the suggestion box? So we got a C10 guy here. That's pretty cool. How long have you had that truck?
We actually dragged it out from behind a gas station when I was 12 years old, rebuilt it from the ground up, and then did two power tours with it, and have put a little over 30,000 miles on it. And then we've blown it back apart down to the frame, and we're doing the full pro touring suspension treatment on it. We get it to where it's something where we can go cruise and have a good, you know, good highway cruiser, along with being able to tear up some autocross cones with it too. So
what, you said you're going to go no limit, and then what motor?
So we've got a four, it's actually going to end up being a four. It was a 406. I think it's going to end up being like a 416, small block.
Okay.
And then, Holley EFI. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then all coil over on a no limit chassis.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's, still stock chassis, but we're using No Limits front clip and the four bar setup, and working with Smitty's Custom Auto on the shock and spring package for it.
Ride Tech Smitty?
Yes.
Yeah. Yep. Okay, cool. So Damron, to rephrase that in the suggestion box, if you could put anything in there, what would you put in the box?
So right now we already have that 79 Blazer, which is the similar generation to the Jimmy that I'm very fond of from when I was younger. So I would have to go with my first muscle car, which was a Fox Body Mustang, 1990.
5.0. I can hear the 5.0 just going right now.
Oh, yes. Yeah. And, we have something really cool on some of our short course trucks, which is onboard audio, where it actually has speakers mounted inside the body to replicate the engine sounds of a full size short course truck. So I would love to have that, replicated Flowmaster 5.0.
Hold on, Vanilla Ice is on the phone right now. Hold on, I need to take this call. Oh, that's so perfect. You could hear a 5.0 coming from a mile away. You still can. I mean, it's such a distinct sound. And a buddy of mine took a 5.0 and put it in a first-gen Bronco, and I just thought that was the coolest thing ever. You know, it's got a distinct sound. So, yeah, that'd be fun. What a fun car that would be.
Yes.
And what would really throw us off is if we had a big block Chevy 454 with some Flowmasters. That's what I have, an orange slice, my 76. And then we could just switch it to a 5.0. You would mess up everybody. You'd be driving by. Dustin would be driving by with this truck, and all of a sudden flip the switch, and it hit, hit the 5.0. Everybody would look. They would look at each other like you guys did when I told you I paid $250 for my TRX. Like, what the hell did he just say? Holy crap, he got a smoking deal. Okay, so we've got both C10 guys. If you think about your Jimmy, you might not be able to do this, but I'm gonna see if I can get Big Fish and the boys that sticker pack for you and send it over to you. Because they did all the work on that GMC. So it's so funny, all the little details, and that's just what they do. He's out of Nebraska. He's a square body fanatic. He has, I'll tell you right now, he has over 50 square bodies, and he has a lot more. I mean, he may have close to three figures of square bodies in a place in Nebraska. Our goal is to get out there in a few months for Power Tour, but word on the street is that I'm not sure if Power Tour is going to be going at the same exact time as we all thought. So we'll see what happens there. But I think that's pretty much everything I have today. Anything else you guys would like to add?
Just appreciate the time today. Great talking cars with you. We're car guys at heart. Pretty much everybody at Traxxas is. So getting to talk cars, whether they're full size or replica scaled down versions like the ones that Traxxas produces, it's a great time. So appreciate it.
Yeah, I'm glad to do it. Fun time. Dustin, anything?
Just go drag your old RC car out and have some fun with it, and get out and enjoy the sunshine if the sun's shining, and stay away from everybody else and wash your hands.
Yeah, stay healthy. Do you find that if guys pull their old stuff out, that they do you guys have an old stockpile of parts, or is it something where they have to upgrade? You know, looking at some of the old stuff online, trying to find, like, again, if I could find a whole new hotshot, I probably would find one and rebuild it. But then I started getting worried that you can't find the parts, because that's where we're so lucky in the old square body and C10 world is you can find parts forever. And I wonder how that works in the RC world. If somebody digs out their old car, if they have a problem getting parts.
So that's one of the cool things about the way that we support our product line is we have parts for trucks going back, 20 plus years that are available on our website and in hobby shops. An example of that, my Nitro car from whenever I was a kid, I was still able to get replacement parts for it, you know, for a car that was built in the mid 90s. So something that we pride ourselves on is being able to support those cars. And it's something that whenever you buy it, it's not, you know, here today, gone tomorrow. That's something that you keep around for a long time. You've got that upgrade path and you can also get all those parts for years to come.
Cool. Awesome. All right, guys, I appreciate it. I love what you said. Get out and support your RC hobby shop out there. These guys are, you know, trying to keep the doors open. Order ahead, get online, dig that old RC car out. I'm going to go out and take my kids and have a little fun with mine today. So thank you guys so much for doing what you do. I look forward to seeing the 6972 coming soon and everything else that Traxxas offers the RC Nation.
Thank you.
Yo, man, let's get out of here. Word to your mother.